human being's body, and we learn about that about 10,000 different species of the microbiomes existing in our bodies. And look at these amazing pictures. This is a normal digestive system of the human being's bodies. And we can see the stomach, the intestines, and these small colorful things are the microbiomes. I mean, the different types of microbiomes. You can see that the structures are different, the type, the color is different, and they show everywhere in our digestive systems. And I already shown some specialized functions for the digestive systems. And right now, the recent studies have shown that the microbiomes have involved in the cancer therapies. And so we move on to the cancer therapy. Cancer. This is the normal cells, which are round and have the regular size, and they replicate normally. And they also have shown the specialized functions in human beings' bodies. But these are the normal cells, which become the mutation cells. You can see that these cells are definitely have the irregularities. The shapes are different, the nucleus become very strange. And these mutation cells can cause the tumor, which is like the cancer. Then they can invade other tissues of the human being's bodies, and they will cause the death finally. And the scientists have already come up with a lot of therapies to cure these kind of mutation cells, cure the cancers. But right now the scientists decide to consider that the microbiomes in human beings' body have the role on the therapies of the cancer cells.
There is current research that shows that there is a relationship between microbiota and cancer therapy. So we decided to dissect a research paper that studied the relationship between microbiota and a drug called cyclophosphamide. So cyclophosphamide has been on the market for about 50 years, and it has been proven to be a very efficacious anti-cancer drug. But research has shown that its efficacy relates to the translocation of gut microbiota to the spleen. So how it works is, write cyclophosphamide as CTX. So CTX goes into the stomach, and what it does, it disrupts the barrier of the cells within the stomach, which lets gram-positive bacteria out of the gut and into the spleen. And what these gram-positive bacteria specifically do is, so there's T cells there's naive T cells, and then the gram-positive bacteria stimulate the growth of pathogenic Th17 helper cells, which are involved in heightening the immunotherapeutic effects of cyclophosphamide. So this research paper, they were able to study this by having two groups of mice, and what they did was they had normal mice, and then in one group of mice, they gave vancomycin, and vancomycin kills gram-positive bacteria. So what they saw was that in those mice, the vancomycin killed the gram-positive bacteria, so there were no gram-positive bacteria to translocate to the spleen, and there were fewer Th17 cells, and the effects of cyclophosphamide were less than the effects that we saw in normal mice. So this research paper basically shows us that the gut microbiota is involved in the efficacy of cancer drugs.
Other therapies in addition to cyclophosphamide has been shown to be affected by the gut microbiota. Specifically, the pharmacokinetics That is how the drugs are absorbed, distributed, metabolized, and excreted in our bodies. Of chemotherapy and immunotherapy are affected by the gut microbiota. The therapeutic range of a drug can be heightened or lessened in response to our microbiota, as we saw in cyclophosphamide. Our microbiota also has the ability to heighten our lymphatic system agents, such as our white blood cells or Th17 cells that we saw in the previous video. A 2017 Nature review article hypothesized that since the gut microbiota has been shown to affect the immune response induced by immunogenic cell death in these two therapies, ionizing radiation therapy, or RTX, might also be influenced by our microbiota. Although our microbiota has a positive effect on cancer therapy, this isn't always the case. Due to our vast and differing microbiotas, heterogeneity of response to drug therapy and susceptibility to toxic effects in cancer patients may be due to differences in gut microbiota composition and activity between individual patients. The human microbiome is still being researched today, and many of its actual constituents remain unknown. Hopefully, through results of the microbiome project, we will be able to understand more about the species that make up the majority of our beings, leading to more individualized medicines and cancer therapies. I feel like that was kind of fast.